recently in New York and invited to present in the UN.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
I have, over the years, been allowed to present, and anyone can, which is so thrilling. You can present an initiative if you have an idea.
How do you get invited?
You have to send your initiative to the United Nations. And I went in and presented this initiative to bring various things to refugees.
When we were at your house, you were mentioning how you can change the refugee camps.
This was something that really hit me, that the average amount of time someone spends in a refugee camp can be 12 years. So I started thinking, why don't we reach to tech companies and start bringing education into refugee camps?
Brilliant.
Why don't we start bringing nonprofit organizations specifically to bring in things, water, seeds, livestock, all the things that can create community? What are we waiting for? This is only going to get more and more and more prevalent.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, your vision on how to make this world a better place is really incredible.
I like to get in and learn how to do everything. So I think—
You really do.
I love it,
yes,
Marta. I just love it.
I know.
And so I've been starting to learn how to do these things. I went to Africa with a water company, and I actually learned from the ground up how to put in water wells. I've worked with Andrea Bocelli. We've put in schools all over the world, in Jordan, in Italy. We brokered a deal between the government and wealthy people in Italy to build a refugee camp in southern Italy, which is almost completed now. These people come with occupations and lives and educations. What can they give? What can they bring? How do we bring them together to create community? To imagine that these people are just dangerous is absurd. Were we?
No.
No.
Not everyone is dangerous.
No.
Well, I could be a little dangerous sometimes, you know.
In your fashion.
Oh.
We're fashionistas.
Single parent, three incredible kids. What experiences from your acting career do you apply towards motherhood?
The first thing that comes to mind is listening, really listening. Your kids will tell you what they need. And because I'm an adoptive mom, I think that's really key. You know, when you think, I didn't adopt till I was 40, and you think, will I know what sound means food and diaper and this and that? And when I first held my first child, I was like, what am I going to do?
What's next?
Yes, but you know.
Yeah.
Women know. We know.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. What advice would you give the new generation of women that are breaking into the industry?
I would have to say that nobody's going to open a door for you. You have to kick the door down. And when you kick the door down, have something to say. And if the only thing you have to say is, I'm going to work harder than anybody else, I'm going to do better than anybody else, and I want it more than anybody else, then you'll be glad you kicked the door in.
Sharon, I'm so excited about this next segment. You have agreed to use your talent and experience to help us identify the next wave of talent. And you have invited someone here to introduce to the world. Tell us about how you came to discover her.
Well, this is really a heartfelt situation for me, because this woman, Christine Crocus, is the dear friend of my business partner. And so I had known her as a friend over the years. And then I had a job in Brazil, and I brought my business partner and Chris with us. I had done the cover of Brazil Vogue and Interior, and they asked me to stay for a party. And we all stayed.
Oh, what a fabulous trip.
Oh, it was so, because what people say about the beaches in Brazil is true. They're just endless, natural, they're wild beaches. We had the most beautiful time. But we had an interesting thing happen to us. We were staying on the top floor of a boutique hotel, and we came up the elevator. We walked out, and that whole wall in front of us was mirrored to the ceiling and down. Mm-hmm. And as we stepped one step out, the entire mirror fell.
What?
And broke into 1,000 pieces on the floor, just missing the three of us.
Oh.
We were so lucky. It just sheared right behind us. That has given me endless pause over the years. And I thought, there was something to that. I don't know. It just affected me very deeply. And since that time,
it was a sign that something good was going to come from this.
I thought so.
Okay.
And as we started to talk, and she started to tell me about this film that she'd been writing for years, I thought, wonder how something's going to happen with this movie. And now she's made this film, and the film is so, so, so beautiful. And I'm very, very excited and proud for her, and I think something special is happening for her right now.
I am so excited to hear more about it. Sharon, thank you so much for coming.
My pleasure.
This is great.
Thanks.
When we come back, Sharon will take the hot seat and interview her first discovery, an amazing new writer, producer, director with her first triple threat feature film, Pimp. Ready for release on November 9th. For What's Hot in Hollywood, from the top of Hollywood, this is Hollywood on Top.